What's going on, guys? My name is Yankee. Welcome back to another video today. Welcome back to the channel as well. It's been a while since we've actually uploaded a video. I really, really do apologize about that, guys. I got really, really sick last week, and I just could not record any video, so I do apologize about that, guys. I don't know if you can still tell it in my voice. I'm still a little sick, but anyway, guys, let's get into this. We're going to be talking about DLC at number 2 in Infinite Warfare. This just got revealed yesterday, guys, and I'm pretty excited about it. There's a lot of things we have to talk about in this video, but anyway, let's get right into this. So this is DLC number 2. When can you guys expect this map pack to be released? It'll be coming out on April 18th, which is about 2 weeks away from now, guys. Pretty excited as well. We're getting 4 multiplayer maps and another zombies map as well. We're not going to talk too much about the zombies map in today's video, but we're going to be mainly talking about these 4 multiplayer maps. We're also getting a remake, which gets me pretty excited as well. So anyway, let's get right into this. The 4 maps are going to be called Turista, Scrap, Archive, and Excess. So I'm pretty excited for one of these maps that are coming to the game. But again, I'm excited for this map, but I'm also like a little like, I don't know like what to feel about this map. So anyway, back in Call of Duty Ghosts, if you guys remember, they also remade a map called Shipment. I don't remember exactly what the name of it was. I'll put a picture on the screen though, so you can at least see what it looked like. And now they're gonna be remaking the map Rust from Modern Warfare 2, coming here into Infinite Warfare. Now, one thing that kind of gets me a little concerned here, when they remade Shipment back in Call of Duty Ghosts, they made the map a little bigger, and it didn't make it so it was too chaotic like how Shipment really plays now, because they add like another exterior layer to that map as well to make it play a little smoother. But also, there was no extra movements in the game, so that's why it still played a little better. Now we're looking at this map Rust coming back from Modern Warfare 2. We all know the movement system in Call of Duty now. It looks like it could be a little weird having this map playing here in Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. There's a lot of boost jumps now. There's a lot of ways to get around the map a lot faster, and I don't know if this map is exactly going to play how people want it to play here in Infinite Warfare. So that's one thing that gets me a little scared. I'm gonna put a picture on screen so you guys can take a look. It does look like they did make the map a little bigger, adding some other layers to the map, but again, it's still gonna be a very, very, very small map, and I don't know if it's going to fit here into the Infinite Warfare style. We all know every single map pack we usually get at least one remake, so I'm really excited that they're continuing that trend, but I just don't know if Rust was the one to go with here on this map. I mean, who knows? Maybe I might be wrong. This might be a really fun map to play here in Infinite Warfare. We're just gonna have to try to find that out in the next couple of days, but anyway, that is the first map that is coming to the game. We're gonna move on to Turista now. Is it nestled in the middle of a giant skeleton of an ancient creature with a sniper spot scattered across a majestic central waterfall. Turista also boasts tight interiors for fans of close quarter combat and 3-lane design that caters to a variety of playstyles. This map just looks really vibrant. The colors pop out a lot. I really do think that these maps are going to be a lot of fun. I always really enjoy playing them, but again, you'll just have to wait and see how the maps play. But I do like the 3-lane approach to these maps. I think that it's going to make it very balanced, and I do think that this map is going to be really fun as well. Then moving on to the next map is going to be called Scrap, and set in an abandoned junkyard on the moon. And Scrap features a combination of extended sightlines and tactical pathways that reward players and engage in both long and short range combat. So taking a look of the picture on screen, again, this looks pretty cool. This map actually does look like a lot of the other maps that are in Infinite Warfare right now. I can't believe like it looks like Scorch. It looks a little bit like, is it Crusher? I don't remember if that's the map I'm thinking about, but I'll put the picture on screen as well of the map I'm talking about. A lot of the maps in Infinite Warfare are very, very similar. They have the same kind of play style. They have the 3 lanes, and they all really seem the same. This looks like it's going to be the same thing, and we are playing on the moon, so again, we're going back into space. As you guys know, we had a mixture of space, and we also get a mixture of maps on Earth. And the final map is going to be Archive, and it's a fast-paced map, and it's a post-future art gallery where tight engagements contrast with open exterior battlegrounds in this wide 3-lane style map. So again, another 3-lane map. I believe all these maps are going to be having this structure as well. I just feel like every single Infinite Warfare map basically has that same 3-lane style to it as well. It's going to be really, really close quarters. Probably going to be really useful to use an SMG on this map. So really cool. I'm really excited about this map pack, guys. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think. And I'm really interested to see how this Rust map actually plays here in Infinite Warfare. I just hope that it plays all right. I'm just hoping it doesn't ruin the map experience while playing this on a futuristic boost jumping Call of Duty game. I'm not too sure exactly how that's going to go. But moving on to the zombies map, I'm not really going to cover that too much, but I will leave a link in the description of a trailer of this map pack as well, and they show a lot more in detail of how the zombies is going to play. It looks pretty interesting, but again, I've really never played any zombies before, so we'll have to figure that out. But anyway, guys, thank you all so much for watching this video. Again, I do apologize for the lack of videos recently, guys. I've been really, really sick. I mean, you can probably still tell my voice. I have to keep making cuts in this video just because I cannot talk for a long period of time. So I'm hoping to get back to streaming soon. I don't know if it's going to be tonight. I don't know if it's going to be tomorrow, but very soon we're going to be getting back to streaming once I can actually talk for for a long period of time. So thank you all so much for watching this video. If you guys did enjoy it, be sure to drop a like, guys. We are gonna be getting back into the swing of things very, very soon. I just had to get this video out for you guys. I felt really bad that I haven't been uploading anything recently. So thank you all so much for watching the video. I'll catch you guys next time, and have a good day, guys, and peace out.